I scared Florida away. Yes, we'll be far away when you watch me in front squad now.
I'm gonna be like one of Nadim's relatives to support him. And then like to eat sand for breakfast. Oh, there's so many vitamins in the sand. Oh yeah. The relationship that I have with Nadim is very unique because I'm his coach, but he's much, much stronger than me.
Bart, I've been following for the longest time, ever since I was like 11 or 12. And then luckily somehow we got in contact through powerlifting. Even before I moved down to LA, I took him in as my coach and he's been coaching me on everything, writing my programs, technique.
Nadim kind of approached me to be his coach and to kind of like mentor him in the powerlifting realm, which I thought was really funny because you have a guy here, when I first met him, he was smashing 455 for 10, and I think I was trying to rep out 315 for 3 on the squats. So he was just hella strong.
I found powerlifting honestly because of him. I watched his first video on powerlifting, and then a month later I signed up for my first meet, and I actually met Bart there. And ever since that day, Bart has always looked up to me and tries to match me at anything I do in terms of like the squat, bench, or deadlift. He always comes up to me. Even though I look at him as my coach, he looks to me as like an inspiration to him. No, I'm just kidding. But like seriously, I do attribute a lot of my strength to him because before that, I was doing the bro version of powerlifting, which was just lift as much weight you can for every single lift, every single day. When I moved down to LA, he was still my coach. He was still helping me out. And even though on some lifts, every lift, I surpassed him, I still look at him for guidance and inspiration because I know he does all the research he can. He practices everything he can and he connects himself with only the best people and people that have proven themselves to be the best.
I don't even know how old he really is, to be honest, but for someone that's almost a 10-year age gap, for him to be that strong, I'm like, dude, you have a lot of potential, and I saw that potential in him from long, long ago. But because he is young, and I call him lazy, although he's harder working than the average person out there, I always never see him live up to his potential. So the rivalry kind of started there.
Thanks.
Watch out, it's too heavy, dude. I'm gonna lift it.
Okay. So, lay on top?
Really, it's really heavy.
Got it.
It's really heavy. Really heavy.
If you guys watch back to an older video where Bart was trying to max out on front squat.
I didn't see anything.
That was Bart's front squat, basically. It was like this. Ah, I dumped it, but the weight was so light, it re-racked itself.
It was at this moment that he knew. He fucked up.
Throughout this whole time, because I think since he was my coach and I had been stronger, there's always been this sort of rivalry between us. You know, like when I easily smash his max for a warm up, he'd come up to me like, dude, that looks slow.
A lot of the times I would tease him like, yo, I'm gonna squat more than you. And he would always laugh, you know, he'd be like, you can't even squat 405 and I'm smashing 405 for like 20 reps. I'm like, you're so true, Nadim. But I just want to tease him, you know?
Now, since I switched to weightlifting, we really can't do that towards each other. There's nothing for us to be like, oh, I clean more than you. And he's like, I don't even clean, you know?
That friendly competition kind of died down a little bit because his competition lifts are so different from mine. But, you know, just kind of like seeing who he is, I always want to motivate him. Like, I know he has a lot of potential. He's extremely strong. Nadim, ironically, even though he can almost back squat 600 pounds, he continuously dumps 315 on the front squat.
The biggest similarity between us was the front squat, and Bart actually, when we're powerlifting, and even now, Bart's front squat smashes on mine. He had a 385 front squat when my front squat was like 275. Even though I had a 585 back squat, my front squat fucking sucked.
And finally, I think just a few weeks ago, he was able to front squat 315. And 315 on the front squat is something that I can manage and I can do for reps with the belt. So we started teasing each other on the front squat. And I'm like, dude, you're never gonna front squat 405. He's like, you're never gonna front squat 405. So finally, we were able to kind of connect again on that friendly competition. I'm like, yo, how about this? we have a front squat competition for New Year's next year, and we have a couple of months to train for it. So even though he's in weightlifting, even though I'm in powerlifting, front squat is a very important accessory to both sports and both disciplines. So we decided we're gonna have a front squat motherfucking battle to see who could hit 405 on the front squat first.
I at least got the crying part good.
Well, that's our new hat, our new barbell hat.
Yeah.
I'm just sad for you because you're gonna get smashed.
By a girl or what?
No, by the weights.
Oh, that's hard.
Gio, come here. Nadine, stand over here.
Bar's trying to do something dumb right now. You guys will see your first person behind the scenes.
I drew someone at the gym. Can you tell me who it is?
Let me see.
Who does that look like?
The gym.
Did you print this from my Instagram or what?
Oh, after you shaved.
After I shaved?
It's before
that's the Dean. That's a throwback Thursday. Yeah,
that's identical.
You drew that?
You're amazing.
I'm an artist.
I honestly thought you printed that like off my Instagram.
Duh, I got mad skills.
It's a little cricket.
Oh, that's the Dean.
Okay, that's
the Dean. That's so good.
Hey, where are we at? 7-Eleven?
Duh.
Hey, that looks like you for sure.
I like how it only has three legs, too.
Oh, yeah.
That's perfect. My long schlong or no?
No, you don't have a long schlong.
No.
My short schlong?
Yeah.
It's photo, like real
oh,
life
no.
size.
Oh no, what are you doing?
Creepy
don't
medicine.
Do that. Don't do that.
Creepy
oh.
medicine.
What is that? Dude, what is that,
hey, guys,
dude?
Like, honestly, like,
dude,
I don't ever
what is this?
Joke around 9-11, even though he does, like,
why would you say something like that? Dude, this is the Hollywood sign.
Like, I grew up during
dude,
that time.
Dude, that's messed up. This is flying. Every airplane flies over the Hollywood. Dude, it's Hollywood.
Honestly,
everyone knows the best 7-Elevens in Hollywood.
Like, honestly,
dude,
like,
that's messed up.
I understand you're trying to
dude,
make fun
of so me.
Dude,
that's so messed up, dude.
But, like, my uncles died too, you know?
Dude, that's really messed up.
My
dude.
Uncles died too during 9-11.
I know, it's so messed up, dude.
That's so fucked up. Dude, and look at Gio. She's, like, mad at you. She doesn't even want to be married to you anymore.
Damn,
I can't even see the camera.
It's messed up.
She's walking away from you.
Damn, it's messed up, dude.
Bart, honestly, you saw my drawing of him. I'm gifted in many ways, from drawing to lifting to doing all these things. And he's been trying to throw off my training. He thinks I needed a spot when he actually needed a spot. You saw how he dumped the weight. If you refer back to him hitting the 305, it looked like fucking, it was a Hurricane Katrina in the gym, and he dropped it. You saw when he dropped 225 the other day, he almost knocked himself out.
In any race that is a long-term race, that's not a sprint, because powerlifting and strength building and weightlifting, they're all marathons, they're not sprints. There's no way you can add 100 pounds to your total in 2 weeks. In any long-term race, if I had to pick a winner between the tortoise and the hare, I will always go with the tortoise, because the tortoise is consistent, takes one day at a time, no shortcuts, and has his eyes set on the goal. Whereas Nadim, the furry rabbit, knows he's strong, so a lot of times he procrastinates. And he'll be like, oh, I can skip this week, or I don't have to do mobility here, or I don't have to do whatever here. But if you add all those things up over the course of 12 weeks, that's like at least 30 hours of training he just wasted away, like 30 hours of mobility he didn't do, hundreds of hours of sleep he didn't get. There are just, over a long term, those really shitty, rabbity habits, they build up. And it produces a huge detrimental effect at the end. Although, because Nadim is much heavier than me, he's like almost 240 pounds, much stronger. He is a very buff jackrabbit, but this buff, gifted jackrabbit is also hella lazy and not dedicated in the gym. So this motherfucker will probably sprint hardcore for 2 weeks and then take like a 2 month nap.
Now, since weightlifting, I've been trying to improve it, and I'm slowly working my way up. I'm around like 335, 340, and Bart, I don't know, he's hit 385 before, but he's kind of weak now because he's cutting, and he will be cutting, and he'll probably be shredded by the time we do this competition. But if everyone does know, being shredded means you're kind of weak. For most people, you know, if you're naturally shredded, then you're fine and you're just building strength. But for people that are naturally fucking fat, like have like a big gut, like Bart, like I don't know how to say it. Like if you see him with that shirt, like fat, like you take his fat and you just hold it in your hand, just that much fat, you know? That's Bart, if you didn't see like fat Bart. It sounds the same, fat Bart, you know? When he cuts down, he's gonna be super weak. So Bart, good luck. And honestly, Bart, because I know you're gonna watch this video because I'm gonna have to show you this video before it goes up, I'm gonna fucking beat you at the front squat. And to everyone watching out there, Bart wants to do it with sleeves and belted, but I'm gonna say fuck it. I'm gonna do it without knee sleeves and without a belt.
Nadeem, I love you with all my heart. And although I'm coaching myself and coaching you for the 405, I'm gonna be very unbiased and I'm gonna help you get to 405 because you accomplishing 405 is gonna make me just as happy. But like always, like it's been proven before, I know you're gonna stray away from the program and I'm gonna have to show you how it's done. I'm gonna fucking front squat 405 in your motherfucking face. And if you hit 405 that day, guess what? I'm gonna hit 425. I'm gonna beat you no matter what. But then if you actually work hard this time, then I'm fucked. So hopefully like mad girls DM you and they wanna come over, they wanna hang out, or like hopefully there's a lot of birthdays in line, because as soon as there's birthdays, hanging out, going out, girls, Nadeem gets sidetracked and he's fucked. So I'm gonna start, what should I do? I think I'm gonna post on Instagram like, yo, Nadeem's single, everyone hit him up. January 4th, Nadeem and I will have a front squat battle for 405. It's gonna be live. Stay tuned and watch that motherfucker, and you tell me who you think is gonna win.